Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, freaks and geeks, trolls and derps alike, welcome. I am Mullet Mike, bringing you yet another episode of Creepy Gaming. If you're just joining us, this is the show where we take a look at all kinds of creepy aspects in video games. In this episode, I will be going over Slender, the 8 pages, and briefly going over the newly released Slender, the Arrival. Special shout out to all these fine folks right here. Thank you very much. Keep those suggestions coming. Without further ado, turn the lights down and the volume up as we journey into some creepy gaming. Fuck! Slender Man, the tall man, Satan's gentleman. He goes by many names, but it's safe to say that the majority of the people know of, or at least have heard, of the Slender Man. If you haven't, then hold tight, we'll cover that in just a second. Becoming a cult phenomenon almost overnight, this urban legend stemmed from the Something Awful forums. There have been many games and stories based off of Slender Man. But today, I will be covering the Slender series, considering they are the most widely accepted Slender Man games out there today. Okay, before I talk about the games, let's get a little background on the Slender Man himself. We have a very special guest today. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce to you my buddy, Bolero. Some of you may be familiar with him. His channel is Bolero's Creepypastas. Be sure to check it out after the video. Bolero, buddy, share with us your knowledge of Slender Man.
Thanks, Mike. For hundreds of years, a long, scrawny, shadowed figure licks suburban wooded forests and preys on children. The Slenderman, the Darkman, the Branchman, the Tallman. A large menacing man, a paranormal creature. It has 8 black vague tentacles that extend from its back and is able to stretch these tentacles at will. It wears a black suit. It can stretch its limbs and torso to inhuman lengths to induce fear into its weak prey, children. Once the Slenderman's arms are outstretched, any victim is put into a hypnotized trance, where then the victim is purely helpless to prevent walking into the Slenderman. It has the ability to create tendrils from its fingertips, which he uses to walk upon. Nobody knows where the victims of the Slenderman goes, whether they are murdered, absorbed, or merely taken to a foreign location or another dimension. There has never been any evidence to construe a conclusion. Slenderman's face is ghost-like, pale, and somewhat appears to be wrapped in gauze. Nobody sees his face the same, it's portrayed to everybody differently. Your deepest, most feared, sinister nightmares. His mannerisms are somewhat polite, or seemingly deviant to his usual behavior. His hands are usually crossed courteously behind his back, or loosely dangling at his sides. His pinstriped suit, his formal black pants, and his perfectly polished dress shoes make him Satan's gentleman. It kills children. It lives in the forest. It stalks groups of miners. It doesn't seem worried of being seen in daylight or being captured in photos. We do not know if its only objective is slaughter. If you feel it stalk you, if your mind becomes feeble and paranoid, it will stalk more and more, showing brief glimpses of its appearance to induce more fear, as if it's a hobby to psychologically torment his victims. It never appears to walk, only float and drift around, pursuing or torturing its victim. Photographs have been taken claiming genuine sightings, seen mostly at night peering in your open windows, or walking in front of lone motorists on isolated roads in the cold, cruel darkness. However still, its main intent is kidnapping children and slaughtering them, as their parents miss them dearly.
Holy shit! Thanks, Bolero. I didn't need to sleep anyways. On June 26, 2012, an independent game known simply as Slender was released for Windows and OS X. This eerie title was developed by Parsec Productions, headed by lead designer Mark J. Hadley. Slender gave mainstream survival horror games of the time, like Silent Hill and Resident Evil, a run for their money. This title is simple, but to the point, showing that you don't have to necessarily spend a lot of money or give this over-the-top presentation in order to be scary. Slender is a perfect example of less is more. When the game starts out, you find yourself in the middle of the woods late at night. The objective is simple. Find the 8 pages without getting caught by Slenderman. This game makes you feel so vulnerable. You have no weapons at all. You're not equipped with anything other than a flashlight, putting the survival in survival horror. Not just that, the same goes for your stamina. You can run, but only for so long. One of the first things I noticed while playing was the sound design. The lack of music at the beginning creates a really creepy vibe. The woods are so still and silent that you can hear your every footstep. Upon your first playthrough, you never know when Slender Man may pop up. It's almost like you could feel him watching you, patiently waiting for the perfect moment, being the gentleman he is. As I stated, you must find each of the 8 pages. They're not always in the same exact location, although they tend to be around the same area. Each page shows some kind of scribble on it in regards to Slender Man. It could be words, like always watching, no eyes, or it could be some kind of drawing, like this sketch of Slender Man blending in with the trees. Throughout the woods, you will find different landmarks. I think that most people will agree with me when I say that the bathroom has to be the sketchiest area in this game. The tight quarters give you that claustrophobic feel and make you easy prey for the Slender Man. Once you collect the first page, the hunt begins. What was once a quiet forest slowly builds into an unescapable nightmare. The ambient soundtrack gradually grows, adding tension to your every step. Slender Man can appear practically anywhere. The trick is not to look directly at him. If you do, game over. Once you collect the 8 pages, the soundtrack immediately stops. You think you've won the game. Before you know it, game over. Now, there are many theories as to what the game's ending means. Is it just a nightmare? Or are you forever trapped in the woods, doomed to run the rest of your life away from Slenderman? Let me know your thoughts and theories in the comments below. To say the game was a hit is an understatement. This title was praised by both critics and players alike. Everybody was talking about Slender. The game grew in popularity. I mean, it's a free download, so it's very accessible. There will be a link in the description if you want to try it out if you haven't already. My point is that Slender is everywhere. Very popular for an indie game. Being a PC title, there are several mods and maps. Known as the Shadow series, these include Slender Sanatorium, Hospice, Elementary, Mansion, Claustrophobia, 7th Street, and Prison, with more on the way. But again, these are fan-made mods. an official sequel was made, Slender: The Arrival. Released March 26, 2013, this official sequel was once again developed by Parsec Production, this time with a little help from Blue Isle Studios. Players will immediately notice the improved graphics and new locations. Slender: The Arrival raises the bar and steps things up a bit by adding a storyline, improved visuals, and some new scares. The story revolves around Lauren and her friend Kate. You start out as Lauren as she begins to unravel a dark mystery. You begin the game going to Kate's house only to find that she is not there and that her house has been destroyed. Slender Man markings can be seen, as well as a mysterious paper. You eventually hear a scream coming from the wooded area outside of the house. Lauren grabs the paper and flashlight and begins an all-new adventure. Just like anything else, the more you play something, the more predictable it becomes. When you first played Slender, it was scary. The more you play it, though, the more you know what to expect. So it's nice getting to play a new Slender game and sharing that same feeling as before, full of surprises, full of suspense, and most importantly, full of scares. Either way, Slender: The Eight Pages is an amazingly creepy game. The less is more approach really made a huge ripple in the video game industry. The Slender series will forever have a place in creepy gaming history. I would like to thank each and every one of you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. The fuck? Filming a fucking YouTube show here. I would like to thank Bolero from Bolero's Creepy Pastas. Be sure to check out his channel in the comments below. Thank you all for watching. I am Ole Mike with... Stay creepy. Thanks for watching. Peace.